Good morning, everyone. Welcome you here to the Holy Spirit Church for this funeral mass for Donna. Your presence here pays tribute to her and is a support for her family and all who love her. It's also a prayer that gives honor and glory to God. We sign ourselves as we are baptized in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our risen Lord Jesus, the love of God his Father, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you. In the waters of baptism, Donna died with Christ and rose with Christ to a new life. May she now share with Christ eternal glory. When she was baptized, she clothed herself in Jesus Christ and his promises. On the day of Christ's second coming, may she go out to meet the Lord with all the saints and angels. Lord Jesus Christ, you have loved us unto death. Let the cross be a sign of your love for Donna and for the people you have gathered here today. Now let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son, Jesus the Christ, who died on the cross, was raised from the dead. He is the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant Donna, who has gone to her rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Please be seated now with the Word of God.
In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd. and sisters, no one lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live for the Lord. And if we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be the Lord of both the dead and the living. Why do you judge your brother, or you who look down on your brother? For the sake we all stand before the judgment seat of God. For it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee will bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. For then each of us will give an accounting of himself to the Lord. The word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading according to the Gospel of John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said to him, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
John. Condolences on this day, that we come with aching hearts, tears shed, right, to the beauty of your mother's life. And all have experienced this, the great gift she was to all of us. And to her daughter, to her sister Renee, her brothers, John and Jeff, and all of her great-grandchildren who she loves so dearly. We've all experienced that, we've all seen it. Distance, we know her great love for her family, the great family gathering she put together as a pastor, understand what went into planning those, the love that went into planning those. She truly loved her family and friends in a beautiful way. She all loved you. She loved all of you very deeply. Right? You were very dear to her. That was one of the common words she used in expressing her love for you. Remember, and I saw it on the funeral website, somebody commented on it, that she always used that word, you. You were dear to her. And sometimes that was a compliment. Sometimes that was a little bit of chastisement. She always used it. She always wanted to know, you to know that you were dear to her. She loved you very deeply. That is the ultimate test. Right? It's how do we love in this life? When we go before that judgment seat, how have we loved? How have we loved our neighbor? How have we loved our family and friends? And we get that great question, the great challenge, how have we loved our enemies? Right? We call to love the other. We enter Holy Week and reflect on this. Christ's love for humanity, his laying down, him giving his life, him being the way for us, shows us that great love. So while I proudly think Donna didn't score a perfect on this test, she did very well, as expressed the beauty of people's testimonies these last few days, the beauty of her friends, family, and relatives, all speaking of this great love, the beauty of all the flowers at the wake last night. I've never seen so many flowers, so much outpouring back to Donna on her hands. She truly gave her life. She gave her life for those that they may have a home, that they may be comforted, that they may know that she was truly dear to them. The words of generosity often come up about Donna's life. Again, what an awesome testimony to her life. To be generous, to be giving, to sacrifice in a beautiful way. She truly loved this community. She gave many things. My family has many graphic edge, t-shirts, and trinkets for me. Right? She just loved others. She wanted to give herself. She understood the strength that came from her faith, the love that she received from the Lord, and wanted to give that back to her daughters, her grandchildren, that they may have the life, that they may know that they're alive and affirmed. Again, that great desire of our hearts is to be known, to love, to be affirmed through God, but through others. And Donna did this in a beautiful way. Right? And the great story for grandson had that opportunity, the ritual of getting a drink of water, letting him be a part of that, letting him be known that he's loved and affirmed in a beautiful way. And she shared that greatest gift of faith. Right? As we heard in the second reading, did you live your life for others? Was it lived for others? Was it lived for God? A beautiful way, as we went through the suffering, as we continue to pray for Donna these last few weeks, we can be assured she died in faith. Right? We come to this beautiful Mass, this beautiful opportunity to appeal to God, for the soul of God. She truly died in the love of the Lord. She truly died in the love of a gift to others. She gives an accounting before the Lord. She can speak of that. And while, again, our hearts are aching, while they are troubled at these times, we know as she goes before the beatific vision, she goes before the Sacred Heart of Jesus, she can testify to this generosity, this love that she had for others, this hope she had for others, that she always saw the best in. She wanted to bring that forth in a beautiful way. Again, that's the ultimate test of our faith. That's the ultimate test of what the Lord does. He gives us the courage, the strength to do so. But how do we give ourselves? So we are assured that she goes before that judgment. And we have the hope of this morning's gospel, this beautiful gospel, one of my favorite for funeral liturgies, for the funeral mass, that we are invited, that Christ has a room for us. Now, it's not guaranteed. I'm not going to sit here and say that. But he does invite us. He does prepare a room for us. He does want us to be with him in eternity. This great invitation. This great invitation as we enter Holy Week. Christ's death on the cross. Right? Dying for you. Looking upon you with that affirmation that he died for you. That he loves you. That he prepares a place for you. Get those great two words, the way, that he was truly human, truly divine, that he bridges that gap, the ultimate merging of the divine and the human, that he is the way, as we conform our lives to him, as we become more Christ-like, as we read the scriptures, as we know him more and more, we know the way, we can fulfill this invitation, we can come closer to him, we know the beauty of him, and that gives us a hope. We are invited to understand the Lord in a beautiful way. Again, Donna, her great motherhood and her great sisterhood, understood that preparing a place for a home. It's a longing of our hearts is to be home. As human, we desire that. We desire this ultimate home of heaven, where we will There's always that longing for the perfection that is found in heaven and with the Lord. And so we continue to pray for Donna, we continue to pray for her soul, that she may know the beauty of heaven, the beauty of this place prepared for us, that she awaits all of us, and as we journey through this life, as we go through this pilgrimage, that our minds and hearts may be focused on that heavenly home, that desire of our hearts in a beautiful way. And so may we be comforted while we feel pain and anguish. May we pray for Donna's healing and joy as she comes upon the wound. While we feel sorrow, may she feel happiness. When we feel the pain of saying goodbye to him, may we rest in, have hope in, pray that she says hello. She sees the Sacred Heart of Jesus, that she comes to encounter him in a beautiful way. That our hearts long for her. They are assured and understand the gift. We hold the memories of all of our encounters with her, all the gift of her love for us in a beautiful way. We continue our journeys. We continue our journeys in faith, that we may join her that heaven, that home. So Donna, eternal rest grant unto you, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon you. May the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Stand for our intercessions. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of his Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. We ask the Lord, hear our prayers. In baptism, Donna received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over to the waters of death, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. She was nourished at the table of our Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet, we pray. Many friends and members of our families have gone before us. And await the kingdom of God. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son, we pray. Amen. Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your law, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace, we pray. Amen. Those who trusted in the Lord, now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, peace, and joy to those whose faith is known to you alone, we pray. The family and friends of Donna seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief, we pray. We are assembled here in faith, confidence to pray for Donna, strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's second coming, we pray. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, Hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus the Christ. Hear the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Mercy, that she who did not doubt your Son to be a most loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Truly right and just, it is our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ, our Savior and Lord. For Christ is the salvation of the world. He is the light of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through Christ, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exalted praise as we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Would you please kneel? You are indeed holy, O Lord. All you have created rightly give you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of your Holy Spirit, you give life to all things. You make them holy. You never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts that we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus the Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, Jesus himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you, for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate this memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your life, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for the faith of God. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Pleased to confirm in faith the church, your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, the bishop of this diocese, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people, your gain for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children, scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Donna, whom you have called from this world to your Son. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly lives after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, too, and to all who are pleasing, their passing from this life. Give kind influence to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory, all honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Please stand for the Lord's prayer. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace on our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. So look not on our sins, look on the faith of your church and the need of your world, and graciously grant her peace and unity and healing in accordance with your will. You who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. His disciples, they recognized him in the breaking of the bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, the old Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be. Lord God, your Son, Jesus the Christ, gave us this sacrament of his body and blood to guide us on our pilgrim way to your kingdom. May our sister Donna, who shared in the Eucharist, come to the banquet of life that Christ has prepared for us. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Donna, and now we come to this farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see her again and enjoy her friendship in heaven. Although we will disperse in some sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another with our faith in Jesus Christ. Into your hands, O Father of mercy, we commend our sister Donna in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of righteousness to your servant. Help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ. Are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. I thank you for your presence here today, your prayer for Donna, for her family. Immediately following Mass, you're welcome to join the family in the Grandman Center for lunch. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.